As beautiful dew in summer brings back life to dry earth, to grass and meadow flowers, making crops grow high. So are friendship and concord, sustenance for the heart. Thus wrote Pentti Lyytinen in his poem, On Consensus. Lyytinen was a Savonian innkeeper and a gifted penner of poems, who wrote down to earth verses in his little notebook, and was fond of reading them out to listeners. In his Book of Our Land, published in Swedish in 1875, the author Zacharias Topelius mentions Pentti Lyytinen and other wordsmiths, who like artisans forged their thoughts into poems and songs. The poems were amusing or sad as befitted the occasion, and often as intelligent and able to touch ordinary people's emotions. These bards toured homes to perform and were invited to special occasions, sometimes at great distances. According to Topelius, they brought Finland's folk song tradition up to date, and it was specifically in Savo, in eastern Finland, that was the birthplace of the new folk songs. In Robert Wilhelm Ekman's painting, completed in 1848, Pentti Lyytinen, who is seated at the end of the table, reads out his poem surrounded by listeners. It is a winter's afternoon, and the cottagers have momentarily taken a break from their chores. The men have lit their pipes, and a fire burns in the oven. Ekman's painting is a carefully constructed narrative of the Finnish lifestyle and people of his day. The artist has depicted the cottage interior in meticulous detail, and at the same time, admiringly, creating an image of a hard-working, harmonious community. The people's clothes are clean and in good shape. Someone in the house can read and write. We are told this by the Bible placed on the windowsill and the quill pen ink bottle. Hanging from a nail is an almanac, and a clock measures out the time. Ekman wanted to give the art public of his day as rich and complete as possible a picture of the life of the people. Coming from southwest Finland, he has also given this Savonian farmhouse some western Finnish touches, such as the bread poles hung from the ceiling, which were not used in Savonia. The baby's cradle is also of the western Finnish type. The person at the other end of the table is probably a Russian peddler. Beside Lyytinen, in front of the kandele, a traditional stringed instrument, sits a man who looks just like Elias Lönnrot. Specifically about this time, Lönnrot was also making his journeys from cottage to cottage, gathering for posterity the poems sung by ordinary people. The Kalevala. The Finnish national epic was published in 1849, a year after the completion of the painting. Ekman's finished painting was one of the first depictions of Finnish folk life. In educated circles, interest in the people and their roots increased rapidly in those years. The nation was being built, and art was showing the way. The painting is one of the most celebrated of Ekman's works. It was the art event of 1848, and according to his contemporaries, an enchantingly beautiful portrayal of Finnish home life. The reality of the lives of people in the countryside was, however, quite different. Ekman's work, in fact, had a clear message: abolish poverty, indolence, and wretched conditions.